الرحمن الرحيم نحمد ونصلي على رسول الكريم اونریبل پیٹرن ملک محمد رفیق رجوانہ گورنر پنجاب اونریبل چیف گیسٹ رانا مشہود احمد خان منسٹر فار ایجوکیشن پنجاب ریسپیکٹڈ ممبرس آف بورڈ آف گورنرس and Board of Trustees, Honorable Dr. Rafiq Ahmed and Dr. Nawaz. I am particularly delighted to see Dr. Rafiq Ahmed, who has made it, and he has witnessed our progress since 1990. He was a part of the Board of Governors of ILM in 1990 and attended the meeting on 16th of June, and then onwards he has been with us throughout the last 25 years. DG UMT Abid Sherwani, my other colleagues, deans and directors of schools and institutes, winners and meritorious achievers of our academic programs who are sitting on my far left hand, members of faculty, my dear happy and proud parents, and graduates who would be inshallah leaders of the future and champions wherever they go. Ladies and gentlemen, Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah. It is indeed a great pleasure for me to welcome all of you on behalf of UMT to this 13th convocation of UMT. And if I add up the preceding convocations which were held under the auspices of Hamdard University when ILM was affiliated with Hamdard University, then it would be 20th convocation. So it's a great day for us, a memorable day for us, that we have crossed a milestone of 20 convocations. Each convocation was becoming bigger and bigger, and we were not able to spend adequate time with each recipient of award and degrees. So we thought we should now, instead of having one per year, let's have two per year so that we can divide the graduates into two. But still, I can see, though we are holding now, this is the second convocation of the year, but still I see it's big, it's large, it's huge, and it's magnificent. So I congratulate all of you who are graduating today in this magnificent ceremony. When I started to think in my mind and heart as to when was it that the first convocation was held, first ever convocation in the history of humankind, so I was lost. I thought maybe when the universities came into being in 12th century or 11th century, when Oxford and Cambridge opened their door, or in 7th or 8th, 9th centuries, when universities came about in the cities of Cordoba, Seville, and Granada. Or maybe a little earlier, when universities came about in Palestine, or at the time of Aristotle, Plato, and Socrates in Athens, when they opened Lahore, when they opened Lyceums. So I then turned a few more pages of the history, and I thought that first convocation, first ever convocation of humankind was held not in this planet, but in the majestic surroundings beyond the scope of time and space in the heavens, when God, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, taught Adam. And then he examined him, he assessed him, he tested him, and in the company of angels he found that Adam came up with all the right answers to all the questions, and Adam graduated. So that was perhaps the first happening, that was perhaps the first convocation in which the first man was educated on the basis of not race or language or color or any other given thing, but purely on the basis of knowledge procured and secured and, of course, produced. So that was the first event in the history of humankind, and that was nothing else but a convocation, the first ever convocation. And then we see a series of convocations being held all over the world. Whenever people got together and they gathered around people who know, people who have knowledge, people who have accumulated wisdom, so people would spend time, and when they were attested and examined and found to be beholden of the same knowledge, they graduated and they were given some kind of testimonials and degrees. To me, the event of convocation is one of the supreme reflection of what humans can mean to other humans. The best thing that a human can do to other human beings is to share knowledge, is to disseminate wisdom, is to enlighten those who don't know, show them the way forward, guide them to their destiny, coach them, train them, and develop them so that they can achieve perfection. And I believe that there cannot be any other activity superior to this basic, fundamental reflection of human essence. And that's why this convocation celebrates, and it holds certain degree of sanctity in the life of those who have taught and in the life of those who have received the knowledge. So this convocation is awareness. It adds to new awareness, a new sense, and a new consciousness of a new position and a new status. And this convocation celebrates the personal attainment of physical, psychological, ethical, social, and intellectual and academic accomplishments. We all gather here to celebrate that, and we all have gathered here to witness that and honor that. It marks the process of knowledge advancement and the journey of individuals in that process. It captures the successes, achievements, and accomplishments of those who were involved, researchers, academics, faculty members, students, parents, and all of their friends and people who are near about them. It also, let me add, that it also symbolizes the aspirations for future. It also symbolizes the dreams that are right now contained in the hearts and minds of those who would receive their degrees. And it also reinforces the hopes that they have for the future. And we are here to wish them well in their future journey. Ladies and gentlemen, honorable patron, I do not have sufficient time to elaborate on the full year report of what we have done through the year that is just about to close. Too many people are engaged, too many initiatives and projects are ongoing, and too many ideas are being turned into action. And even at the moment, I am not fully cognizant of what is done and what is being done by respective members of faculty. It has become so big that even I am not aware of the individual accomplishments of our graduates who would be walking today over this stage. And I cannot assess, truly gauge the impact of what has gone before us. So I would simply present to you some fundamentals so that you can, which will manifest where we stand and where we are heading. Our first 10 years have been years of emergence, and our years of setting up, our years of formation, and now we are moving from formation and emergence towards eminence and excellence. That is the key banner headline that I can vouch for, that I can promise, and that you would be able to see down the road. So we are now working towards doing